Hey there, welcome to this tutorial on the Archive, a powerful, minimalist note-taking app for Mac that's designed with knowledge workers like you in mind. I'm your host, Christian, and today I'll be showing you everything you need to know about creating notes in the Archive. Whether you're just getting started or looking to level up your workflow, by the end of this video, you know all the different ways to create notes and some pro tips to make your note-taking more efficient. Let's dive in! The most straightforward way to create a note in the Archive is by using the keyboard shortcut Command N. This is probably familiar if you used any Mac application before. You can also access this from the menu by clicking Note, New, or if you prefer, using the mouse, simply right-click in the notes list and select New Note. When you create a note this way, it starts with the title Untitled. To rename it, press Command R or go to Note, Rename. Now, let me show you one really cool feature, the Quick Entry Helper. This is perfect when you're in the middle of something else, like browsing the web or reading a PDF, and want to capture a thought without losing focus. By default, the shortcut isn't set, but I recommend setting it to Command Control N in your app's preferences. Next to this setting, let's also change the default title of a new note from Untitled to Timestamp, which allows us to generate date and time-based addresses for notes. When triggered, a floating window appears, allowing you to quickly jot down your thoughts. The default title is pre-filled, usually with Untitled or the timestamp, and then you can change it right here in the text field. Once you're done, just hit Create and your thought is captured in your note archive immediately, without you having to bring the app to the front. This is incredibly powerful for researchers, writers, or anyone who constantly needs to capture ideas while working on something else. Now for a more powerful approach, using the Omnibar. This is where the archive really shines. The Omnibar is the search field at the top of the application. It's more than just a search tool. Let's say you want to create a note titled Project Ideas for 2025. Simply type that into the Omnibar. If no existing note matches your search, just press Enter and boom, a new note is created with that exact title. Now, to show you an even cooler approach, let me remove this empty new note and show you how you can do this in a totally different way. This method is incredibly useful when you're in the flow of the work. Here's why this matters. When you're in the process of writing one note and mention a concept that deserves its own, you can use what's called a wiki link and format it like this. Notice the double brackets? In the archive, when you click on this link, the underlined text inside these double brackets, it will search for Project Ideas for 2025 via the Omnibar as if you type that phrase. If the note doesn't exist yet, just hit Enter to create it. This is sometimes called the link first approach, where you create structure first, then fill in the content. This powerful integration between search, linking, and note creation makes the archive perfect for building a connected knowledge system with super simple processes. And there you have it. You now know multiple ways to create notes in the archive. First, using Command N or the File menu. Second, using the Quick Entry Helper. And third, creating notes from the Omnibar and the search and using links to start this process. Remember, the power of the archive isn't just in creating individual notes, but in building a network of connected ideas. In upcoming videos, we will cover searching and linking between notes to build your knowledge system and what should go into a note. If you found this helpful, please hit like, subscribe, and let us know in the comments what aspect of the archive you'd like us to cover next. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day.